Hi everybody, today you will be learning Nagoriyuki. Mr. Bloodsucking Universe himself, he is an excellent monster of controlling space and controlling the pace of the game in the right hands. While this big fellow will give you the difficult task of walking his tightrope of blood, he is like a beautiful manual transition car. Starting out very clunky as you learn the ins and outs, he becomes a beautiful, beautiful character to control once you get mastery of him, and is honestly beautiful to watch. Now before going into anything else, you're going to need to know how this works. Each of these three sections are their own level. At each level, he will get closer and closer to popping until finally he takes on his vampiric state and loses half of his health over time. Now, this penalty is much more severe if you look at the second half of his health bar because he has a massive guts rating, making it much harder for the enemy to chunk through than the first half. This depletion is on top of whatever punish they get because during that big animation he does, the opponent can run up and combo him. However, if he does hit them in the air, they will fly back to full screen, and if he hits them close, he will only be -7 because they go into a kind of guard break stance. So this is a state that you usually never want to get to. Not only do you lose your health, but it also locks you out of his special moves, which are a huge part of Nagoriyuki's game. While he is lacking in a normal dash, as well as an air jump, he has special moves that can combo into each other and also fulfill some of these roles. We'll be going into each of those in their own section, but understand that for the most part, all of his special moves will add 90% of a single gauge to his blood meter, except for his dash, which adds 43%, and his command grab special, which will deplete the entire thing pretty much. It's 280%, so you know, almost three. It's important noting that also using this command grab will completely erase all of the built-up additions he was going to have. So when you're about to pop, landing it will effectively set you right down to 20% of one single one. Blood can also be depleted by landing any of his sword attacks, primarily as heavy slashes are the best ones to get, as all of them will decrease on hit a blood meter by 57%, and on block will be 7%. Now, the benefit of getting these gauges filled up is that these heavy slashes will get faster and get a little bit more range with each meter. What makes that so strong? Well, let's go over it. Now, first, his neutral game. Close to him, Nagoriyuki has a plethora of options. His standing punch, standing kick, and close slash are all incredible close range moves. Now, his standing punch will come out in 5 frames, and his standing kick and slash are both 7 frames. While his standing punch and kick are 0 on block, his close slash is +3. One of the rare plus frame moves in this game. Now, standing punch is a good anti-air, but honestly, his 6P is phenomenal. Massive hitbox and can go into some confirms we'll go over in a bit. For covering the ground close to him, he has a normal crouching punch and kick. Like, they're quite good, but his forward kick is very interesting because it's a nice stomp that does hit low, but also can step over some moves that are going low. The true masterful move, though, of the ground is his crouching slash. Its recovery is quite strong for its range, so you can just kind of keep throwing it out, unless the opponent really gets the read and air dashes in. But again, your 6P is phenomenal covering that, and if they're really far away, 2H, especially as you stack levels of blood meter, is amazing at covering the airspace. And on block, we'll push them further away anyway. Standing heavy slash and standing far slash are both very good at covering the space in front of him, and as far as his jumping moves go, they are all good, they're decent, but they are not really worth going into because he is quite a grounded character, and they really do just kind of cover the spaces that they show. Have fun with it, but it's way more important we go into those really good specials I mentioned before. Now, starting off in place of his dash is his movement Fukio. This move is awesome. It's a sliding dash, which again, doesn't even fill up half of a blood meter. And if you want to shorten it, you can stop immediately by holding back or forward, the opposite direction that you essentially input the dash. This move can allow you to establish your space, especially on the opponent's wake up, incredibly well. Another move that's incredible for his neutrals is quarter circle forward slash, Zaramayuki. This move will cut through any single hit projectile and still continue going. Because this move can be canceled into from other special moves, you can go in with your teleport to take advantage of the +5 frames of block the clone will put the opponent into, or you can go into this amazing move, which is the Beyblade. I'm sure you've all seen this when fighting Nago, and for very good reason. This lunging attack is at worst 0 on block. You heard me, 0 on block. If spaced right, it is +2 on block. It is so amazing, in fact, that it almost kind of becomes a new Nago's player's weakness because they will feel like they should always be throwing it out, and it very much can lead you to pop. This is also an amazing transition into confirms because goddamn does this move have some really good confirms. Now, one of the biggest concepts you'll get with Nago is confirming OTGs into true hits. Now, many moves will cause knockdowns that are OTGable, but this Beyblade will always do that. His 6H does so much damage that this is always a phenomenal OTG move to get massive damage and get 57% of a blood gauge back. That's right, OTG hits will still give you blood back. Now, from any blood gauge level, this 6H will hit someone who falls to the ground if the Beyblade hits close to the person. However, at level 1, you might have to do a teleport after a spaced Beyblade, because the range of the 6H at level 1 is not long enough to always hit. On hits, counter hit or normal, this is where this move gets honestly crazy. On counter hit, it's a lot easier. You can go into close slash and then go into a teleport and keep going for barely any blood to start a real big combo up. But even on normal hits, you can go into his biggest confirm that's important for combos, which is doing his DP motion 623 Shizuriyuki. If you let this move rock, on hit or block, it will go into a second slash down. However, you can cancel this first hit into a teleport forward. So this lets you scoop up even a normal hit Beyblade into a potentially full combo confirm. Granted, if you have the blood to do so, because it does cost a lot. Now, I didn't want to say it in the neutral section, but Shizuriyuki is also a pretty decent anti-air, in all honesty. But I would say while you're getting used to it, do not think of it as anti-air. He has other strong ones, and even on whiff, you will gain blood for using these special moves. So it's really not too great to use unless you're pretty sure you can turn it into a combo and get your blood back down. Or just like freaking kill them, you know? As far as smaller confirms go, going from his like standing punch into forward punch into Beyblade, that's really good. Same with standing kick into those. And that's the thing where combos and confirms really do blend for Nagoriyuki, because blood permitting, you can go into the Beyblade, scoop them up, and turn a small confirm into a full meterless combo. Now, just some smaller confirms before we go into those full combos. As your blood increases, like I said, you can get a thing like a Beyblade into a 6H without a teleport, or you can at levels 2 and higher, get a crouching slash directly into a heavy slash. While it might sound small, it's very good to know. And if you do end up popping with Nago, that is when his blood is at its highest and all you have are your normals. So that can be a really good Gatling to then go into his super, which does massive damage and will put you out of blood state. Confirming this is really important because you might feel like throwing it out in neutral to get out of blood state, but it has a whopping 66 frames on block of disadvantage. So, I mean, you're probably getting punished after throwing it out. Now let's go over some final pieces of combo theory for Nagoriyuki. After doing a lot of his teleports, it is really good to do standing kick or a close slash because they really push the opponent up and they kind of let you just repeat these loops of juggling them. Continuing far slash gives him a target combo of 3 slash hits, which is very strong for corner carry, and its final hit decreases blood by a massive 120 some percent of a blood meter. Even on block, the third hit will decrease a blood meter by like 60%, but you kind of want to have RC for that because it's quite unsafe. You also do not have to opt for that third hit and can instead go into his Shizuriyuki to continue the combo going from there after the massive corner carry. Because of how fast his close slash is in the corner, you can do one, bounce them up, and then do another if you wait the allotted time. And as long as you're bouncing them up, finishing off with that forward heavy slash, oh man, does that do damage. His cinematic super is amazing. It does a lot of damage as well, kind of in line with this character, and decreases blood by a massive 194% of a meter. But keep in mind, you need to let the whole thing finish its cinematic to do so. If you RC it early, you will not have the blood decrease, which, you know, might throw a massive wrench in your game plan. And speaking of RCs to cancel stuff, from his grab, or especially Bloodsucking Universe, doing a fast RC into close slash into whatever follow-up you want is incredibly strong. As more than anyone, him having such high damage makes skipping the empty hit of a red roaming cancel really increase damage output. So with all these tools, Nago is someone who allows you to change up your pacing in an instant. I mean, you can go from being someone who's like ducking in and out of their ranges with really safe moves to a character straight out of Samshow just cutting through space. Now, despite all these options, you do need to still be very patient, as mistiming a single one of them and getting punished will still net you that 90% of blood. It really is all about choosing those perfect timings, as even a slight misstep can then put you in a state where you can't approach and now you are getting zoned out. So get used to mixing up between all of your really safe normals and your grabs while close. While of course normal grab can be throw teched, it's really strong because if you do a quick teleport back and they're expecting a grab and they go for, you know, a throw tech, you can then get a counter hit forward heavy slash and truly make them just explode. Speaking of grabs, his air grab will always let you OTG. This is not the case with the one on the ground, but it will work with the one in the air, netting you massive damage and letting you take advantage of all the stuff that we talked about earlier. Now keep in mind, just like a lot of other characters, he'll have a lot of really high damage routes in the corner, but his is even more than most because he is damage the character. And the corner is for sure your favorite place to have your opponent. Now keep in mind, while I think he has many more strong options to take advantage of, he does of course have a grounded overhead and his charge dust, and it can be a good thing to go for to get back a lot of your blood. Simply go for jumping heavy slash, kick, jump out of that, heavy slash, kick, heavy heavy. Or if you want to keep a little bit of your blood, you can instead opt for a slash slash. Lastly, don't forget to take advantage advantage of canceling all the specials into each other. On a Beyblade on block, you can cancel into your command grab to just chomp them, because the only way they can really beat that is by jumping out or an invincible super. But if they try and jump out and you do a close slash, I mean, the amount of risk that they're gonna build up because you're plus, they explode and die. Also, we had said before you can go into his scoop after the two hits of the far slash combo. Now, you can also, instead of going for that, opt for a command grab to trick them out while close, or go into a back teleport and do the whole mix and hits. So putting this all together, we have a character that will transform as the fight goes on, and as a well-oiled machine, if you recognize all the correct moments, you can dispatch your opponents in seconds. Close the gaps with all of his different special moves and threaten the opponent's jumping and their space with his far-reaching slashes and his incredibly safe and fast close-hitting normals. Change up tempos of speed, change up whether you're doing grabs or hits. Knowing the right moments to pump the gas will let you completely control the pace of the match. And so long as you don't get too antsy and throw out a move too early and really stand your ground, you have the opportunity to turn every single round into a Twitter clip in your favor. Now that's everything for this character guide. I hope you learned a lot about Nago. I think he's such a cool addition to the Guilty Gear universe and a very successful new character design. He really makes me excited for any of the new characters that they got coming for us. With all that said, if you learned something, please consider hitting the like button, as it really does help this reach even more people who want to learn like you, and helps the channel grow, which truly is really dope to see. I hope you have a great rest of the day, and if you want to keep on the Guilty Gear learning train and learn more about this character here, Axel, whether it's getting in on him or playing as him, hey, look no further than right here.